Hey, it's Jesus from LowCode, and today I want to show you a company dashboard that we build using Glide apps. So this is an example, a demo of a dashboard that we built for ourselves, and we're using this internally for myself, the owner, and for our team members to keep track of a bunch of things. So basically, I'm looking at the dashboard as one of our contractors, right? So basically, when they log in, they see this dashboard. And here they have the first thing that they see is the announcements. So I can provide announcements that they need to read, etc. And then they'll click on the announcement, see the details, etc. And then they'll click here, this dismiss button, and then we'll hide that announcement. So they don't always have that thing. When I publish a new announcement, it'll show up at the top and they have to read it. And then I can keep track of who has read what, right? Then we have here their income, their invoices, sales performance, and like vision and mission and stuff that's specific for us. The functionality starts here in the logged hours. So basically what they're doing is they're coming here, clicking the plus button here, and they're entering a task number related to where that task was assigned to them, either in Plutio, which is our client portal, Slack, email, Asana for some of our clients, Make, etc. So they'll enter the task number, the task name, the project, where they can add a project, add how many minutes they spend on this task, add their hourly rate, add notes, and then that'll start creating this log of tasks that you see here. Eventually, at the end of the week, at the end of the month, depending on how they are billing us, they'll come here and click the add button, and then they'll be able to select any of the tasks that they logged previously during the week or during the month and generate an invoice. So at the end, they'll generate an invoice like this with a list of tasks. So in this case, there's only one task. There's a fixed amount for whatever reason. And then we're generating with PDF Monkey, we're generating a PDF for that invoice, and they're submitting that invoice through the portal. So actually you can see here that it was just loading the invoice. Here we go. So by default, this invoice will show up as pending, and then on the admin side, we'll get a notification. I'll show you that in a second. Then they can always request days off using this form. So again, they'll click the plus button here, either have a day, full day, or multiple days. If it's multiple days, they'll select a start date and an end date, click submit, and that will send us our request. All of these requests, invoices, days off, etc., are pinging us in our Slack. We have an admin channel in Slack, and then that way we keep track of everything that's happening here. We could also do like in-app notifications, email, stuff like that. And then something that we haven't used is this rating. So this allows us to, for everybody in the team to rate each other. So basically they will just come in and rate Cecilia at the rating. What does this colleague grade at? What could they do better? And then this is anonymous for them, but not for us on the admin side. Now, if I show you the admin side, so I log in as an admin. Here I have some metrics in terms of our sales and budgets, etc., pending items, how much I owe our team, how many days off I have to approve. So basically in this case, if I click on the pending days off, I'll go here to the days off, and I can see that I rejected this day off for this employee, I approved this for this other employee, and then I have this one pending. So basically I would come into the pending one, and then approve or reject it, and that will send them a notification through the app itself and in Slack as well. And that allows us to keep track of this calendar, and we can link this to a Google Calendar or something else if we would want to. Same process with the invoices. Basically, we'll see here the invoices. I have the spending invoice. I would come in here and then pay that invoice through our bank or whatever way you're paying the invoice. And then here, I'll upload a file or enter a link like with a proof of payment that will allow me to click a button, and then they'll notify the employee or the contractor and change the status of the invoice from submitted to paid, right? And then that's a very easy way for us to keep track of all the invoices that we have to pay internally. Another cool feature about this app is that I can manage all of our projects here, days off, the project manager review. So basically we're asking clients to review our project managers, every interaction that they have. So right now we have two project managers, and then using this same app, actually let me show you that right now. So what everybody else sees is this screen. So if you're a client of LowCode, you will, every time you speak with the project manager, they'll send you this link. You'll enter, you can do this anonymously, but you'll enter the project name, select your project manager, rate them, and add a comment. And that is feeding that page that I just showed you here on the admin dashboard and allows us to keep track of how our clients feeling in terms of working with us and our team members. So let me go back to, okay, so here we're back on the admin dashboard. I can modify my targets, and then here I have my announcements tab. So basically I'll click a plus button here, add a name, a timestamp when I want this to be released, and a body. And when I do that, we have something like this, right? Upcoming changes related to PTO. So this is the thing that will show up on everybody else's dashboard for them to read. So in this case, I've already read it and dismissed it. Then if I preview this as someone else, then it'll show up here. Everybody apparently has read this thing. It'll show up here at the top of their dashboard. So that's just a very simple example of what can be done using Glide apps. And us at LowCode, we are the best no-code Glide apps agency. We've built 300 Glide apps. We've built a lot of internal apps for businesses. So get in touch with us. We can help you build an internal employee dashboard for your company. Thanks for watching.